Welcome back students. Now in this session we are going to learn about prehistoric Tamilagam. Okay, the first one, Lower Paleolithic culture in Tamil Nadu. One of the oldest stone age tools in the world made by human ancestors called the hominis. So hominis is called as one of the old human ancestors had been produced in Tamil Nadu. So the old stone, in the old stone age time, the hominis, they are lived in our state. These stone tools are found near the Chennai region, several sites, especially at Adhirampakkam. Okay, so in the place of Adhirampakkam have a lot of resources in the old stone age people's things. The archaeological excavation at this site and cosmic ray exposure dating of the artifacts suggests that people lived here about 1.5 to 2 million years ago. So these two artifacts give more information about the Lower Paleolithic peoples. The Kosatalaya River is one of the major cradles of human ancestors in the world. So in the ancestors people, most of the peoples are living in this river bank. The people who lived here belonged to the species of Homo erectus. So the people are lived in the river bank of Kosatalaya is called as the Homo erectus. So archaeological excavation means to digging undertaken to recover archaeological evidence such as stone tools, pottery, animal bones and pollens in order to understand the past lifestyle. So that means archaeological excavation and agalaraivunu solrom illaya agalaraivu indha keeledi agalaraivu ellam kelli pottringala. So adhu dhaan excavation. So the excavation edhukka venna andha kaalathula use panna things la kandupidichada indha kaalathu humans oda lifestyle eppadi irundirukendradha therinjikka mudiyum. Okay, next one, cosmic ray exposure. So cosmic ray exposure means a method in which exposure to cosmogenic rays is used for dating the sample. So on the things oda year in the year use pannunra therinjikradhukaga dhaan idhu use pandrom, cosmic ray exposure dating. So okay, so understand the years. Okay, next, in 1863 Sir Robert Bruce Foote, a geologist from England, first discovered Paleolithic tools at Pallavaram near Chennai. Okay, so first he discovered some tools, Paleolithic tools in Pallavaram. They are the earliest finds of such tools in India. Hence, the hand axe assemblages were considered at Madras stone tool industry. Okay, hand axe, the Paleolithic age use panna hand axe enge irukku Madras stone tool irukku nu kandupidichara. Nowadays that hand axe is placed in the Chennai museum. The tools that he discovered are now housed in the Chennai museum. So the hand axe ipo enge irukku Chennai museum la irukku. It was excavated by Sir Robert Bruce Foote. Okay, the Paleolithic people hunted wild animals and gathered the naturally available fruits, roots, nuts and leaves. They did not have knowledge of iron and pottery making, which developed much later in history. So in that early Paleolithic period, the people have any knowledge about iron and pottery making. They have only stones, used in stones, and their workings are hunting and gathering. Okay, hand axes and cleavers are the important tool type. So cleavers means and kutti kilikkiradhu cut pandradhukku use panakoodiya oru tool. Okay, hand axe pandradhu and dig pandradhukku maratha cut pandradhukku use pandradhu. Okay, are the important tools type of Lower Paleolithic period. These tools fitted with the wooden and bone handle were used for cutting, piercing and digging. okay. So these all tools are helped to cutting, piercing and digging. தோன்றதுக்கு புதைக்கிறதுக்கு கட் பண்ணுறதுக்கெல்லாம் ஹெல்ப் யூஸ் ஆயிருக்கு. The people of this time used hammer stones and spherites. Spherites means the tools are shaped in spherical shape. Okay, the quartzite bubbles and cobbles are chosen as raw material. So, pallinga karkala adhiyam use pannirukanga. The tools are found in the soil deposits and also in the exposed river side. So, all these tools are excavated in the soil deposits. River bank la adhigama enna iruka indha mai tools la eduthirukanga. They occur at Pallavaram குடியம் கேவ், அதிரம்பாக்கம், வடமதுரை, எருமை வெட்டிப்பாளையம் அண்ட் பறவைக்குளம். ஸோ தீஸ் பிளேஸ் ஆர் த ஆர்கியாலஜிக்கல் எக்ஸ்கவேட்டட் பிளேசஸ். ஸோ லாட் ஆஃப் த டூல்ஸ் ஆர் எக்ஸ்கவேட்டட் இன் தீஸ் பிளேசஸ். ஸோ தீஸ் ஆர் த லாட் ஆஃப் தி எக்ஸ்கவேட்டட் திங்ஸ். The lower Paleolithic tools are also found in North Arcot and Dharmapuri districts. The people belonging to this period under basalt rocks for manufacturing artifact. So artifact means the tools are made by human. The basalt rock, basalt rock means there is a strong rocks. These rocks are made by volcano eruption. However, the southern part of Tamil Nadu and Sri Lanka do not have evidence of lower Paleolithic culture. Basalt rocks are igneous rock. Igneous rocks are those formed from the molten lava from the earth. Already I am saying that basalt rocks are formed by igneous rock. Igneous rocks are due to the formation of volcano eruptions. This is a formation of lava. So the basalt rocks are very strong. The lower Paleolithic culture is datable to about 2 to 1.5 million years ago. Adhirampakkam. This culture pace continued in other parts of India up to 60 years ago. So to 1.5 million ago, so 60,000 years that place is called as the lower Paleolithic culture. Okay, next one is the middle Paleolithic culture in Tamil Nadu. In the course of time, the middle Paleolithic culture emerged during 385,000 to 172,000 years ago. Okay, so the middle period, during 385,000 to 172,000. Okay, the tool type of this period underwent a change and smaller artifacts. The human made things are very small. In a lower Paleolithic period, the people used a heavy basalt rocks. Okay, so the rocks and the tools are very heavy. But in the middle Paleolithic culture, the people made a tools in smaller artifact. Okay, coarse flax, crabbers, knives, spores, liver. Levelizing flax, hand axe and cleavers are the artifact types of this period. So coarse na karunkal solo, strong ana black karunkal solo. Next one flax na kar chedilgal adile vende maatrangal karuk and the shape of the stone ode shape of the stones differs from other stones. Okay, compared to the previous phase, these tools types became smaller in size. So lower Paleolithic compare பண்ணும்போது middle Paleolithic culture tools எப்படி இருக்கும், smaller in size. In the southern part of Tamil Nadu at T. Pudupatti and Sivarakkottai, artifacts of the middle Paleolithic tools have been collected. Also near Tanjavur and Ariyalur, similar artifacts have been found there. So Pudupatti, Sivarakkottai, Tanjavur, Ariyalur districts la excavate pandra things la epa use pandrathu middle Paleolithic time la. Okay va, next one, Mesolithic culture in Tamil Nadu. In many parts of the world and in same parts of India, the upper Paleolithic culture succeeded the middle Paleolithic culture because in the upper paleolithic culture, lot of the innovations is happened. The human cognitive skills also developed in that particular time. There is no evidence for the upper paleolithic culture in Tamil Nadu. There is no evidence. Okay, but the people who used microliths are small stone artifacts. So microlithic means small stone tools. Lived in many parts of Tamil Nadu. Since this culture period occurs between Paleolithic and Neolithic culture, it is known as the Mesolithic culture or Middle Stone Age. So these are the microlithic flags. So these are the small stones, stone tools. Okay, yeah. But in the lower Paleolithic, big stones were created. But in the Middle Paleolithic and Mesolithic time, very microlithic tools only used. Okay. Evidence for the existence of Mesolithic hunters gatherers is found at Chennai, Nathaarka, Dharmapuri, Salem, Coimbatore, Arayalur, Trishrapalli, Pudukottai, Madurai, Sivagangai, Tirunelveli and Kanyakumari. So lot of the evidences happen in these places. Chennai, Nathaarka, Dharmapuri, Salem, Coimbatore, Arayalur, Trishrapalli, Pudukottai, Madurai, Sivagangai, Tirunelveli and Kanyakumari. So these are the places for excavating places. There are found a lot of evidence of Mesolithic culture. The three sites near Thoothukudi have evidence of microlithic artifacts. Okay, these sites have red sand dunes called Theris. So the Thoothukudi place also called the Theris sites because these place have a lot of red sand dunes. Okay, the people of this period used small artifacts made of chat and quartz. So chat na vandu எப்படி சொல்கிறதுனா குவாட்ஸ்னா பளிங்கு கற்கள், சேர்னா பீசஸ் ஆஃப் பிக் ஸ்டோன்ஸ். த டூல் டைப்ஸ் ஆஃப் ஸ்கிராபர்ஸ், லூனைட்ஸ் அண்ட் ட்ரையாங்கிள்ஸ். தீஸ் பீப்புள் ஹண்டட் வைல்ட் அனிமல் அண்ட் கேதர்ட் ஃப்ரூட்ஸ், நட்ஸ் அண்ட் ரூட்ஸ் ஃபார் தர் சப்சிஸ்டன்ஸ். ஓகே, ஸோ இந்த மிசோலித்திக் கல்ச்சர் த பீப்புள்ஸ் ஆர் யூஸ்டு இன் த டைப்ஸ் ஆஃப் டூல்ஸ் டைப்பர்ஸ் scrappers, lunates and triangles and people doing hunting and gathered fruits, nuts, roots. Okay, scrappers means tools used for scrabbing the surface. Scrabbing na thodaikkirathu sorandrathu solluvom laya, ipo nam scrapper vechirukkom vegetable cut pandradhukku and mele skin remove pandradhukku vechirukkom laya, that is called as a scrapper. Scrabbers are similar to the tools used in the kitchen for removing skin of vegetable. So vegetable skin remove பண்ணுறக்கு ஒரு tool வச்சுருப்போம் இல்லையா, that is called as a scrabbers. Triangles are tools in the shape of triangles. Lunettes are the tools in the shape of crescent. Okay, so these three types of tools are used in Mesolithic culture. Okay. Next one, Neolithic culture in Tamil Nadu. The culture that domesticated animals and cultivated crops is called Neolithic. So we have to already learn in the last session. Okay, so Neolithic means a lot of Neolithic revolution because the people's cognitive skills are developed. So the people domesticated animals and cultivating crops. So they are originated agriculture. The Neolithic people used polished stone axe called celt. Cattle rearing was their main occupation. They lived in small villages with houses made thatched roof and walls plastered with clay. Okay, so before the Mesolithic and Middle Paleolithic people, the peoples are living in nomadic people, Naludigal. So place to place they are moved from place to place. But in the Neolithic culture, peoples are settled in particular places. They are built some houses. They used the materials of thatched and clay. So because they have started the cultivation, so they stay settled in some places. Evidences of Neolithic villages found at Payampalli in Velur district and few sites in Dharmapuri region. So Neolithic people perhaps devises the first pottery. They made pottery. using a slow wheel called tan table or made pottery out of hand. So in the wheel parts seivaangale adhe epa start aachu neolithic period la. Okay, first before firing the pottery was polished with bubbles. This process is known as the burnishing. Merugutvaanga. Okay, and nowadays the pot adha enna pannuvaangala neruppula vachu heat pannuvaangala, but neolithic time la adha heat pandrathukku munnadi adha enna pannuvaanga, polish pannuvaanga. So that process is called as a burnishing, merugutudal. Payampalli is a village in Velur district of Tamil Nadu. The earliest evidence for the domestication of animals and cultivations of plants is found at this site, which was excavated by the Archaeological Survey of India. Evidences for pottery making and cultivation of horse gram and green gram has been found in this village. So in the place of Velur district, the peoples are doing domestication of animals and cultivation. So they are cultivate horse gram and green gram and pottery making. Okay, now I end this session. Thank you, students.